If you were experiencing foundation issues, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
We premiere our Star Student of the Month for another year, and we're joined this morning by Senior John Murphy over at B.B. Comer High School. John, good morning to you.
Good morning, sir.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, John.
Well, I'm a student at high school. I'm a senior at B.B. Comer. I plan on furthering my education after I graduate and finish my AIT portion of my basic training. Mm-hmm. I play some sports. I used to play some sports. Now I focus on track and field. I'm a mid-distance runner. I used to play football, but I kind of just lost interest over the years. Still watch it, but...
What about your family?
My father is also John Murphy, and then my stepmother is Tammy Jones, but they're married now, so it's Tammy Murphy.
There you go. There you go. Now, 3.7 GPA. You're a senior over at B.B. Comer, and you got a busy schedule. How's it been so far this year? What are we in, a month or so into the school season?
My teachers are fairly nice so far. In the English department, I've had a lot thrown on me. She gives out a lot of homework, but it hasn't been too much to handle. I'm transitioning very well.
Okay. John Murphy is our Star Student of the Month senior over at B.B. Comer. And I've never had a student in the years we've been doing our Star Student quite like that describes John, because John is in the military. And tell us a little bit how that transpired and what's going on with that.
Well, I love the military so far. And over the summer, you know, I learned a lot from it. It's great. It's terrible while you're there.
What did you do?
I got beat up a lot. It was rough every day.
Is your basic training, correct?
Yes, sir. Basic training.
And I really, when I was talking to John earlier, I really didn't know that you could do basic training while in high school. How does that work?
Okay, so at the end of your junior year, over the summer, you go to basic training when you're 17. And then the following year, which will be this year, my senior year, this summer I will go to AIT or infantry school for me, finish that out, and then I'll be assigned to my unit.
Why the military?
Well, there's a lot of benefits to being in the military. I've had family in the military. Mm-hmm. My grandfather served. My uncle is still actively serving right now. I want to be able to pay for college very easily, make my family proud.
Well, you make us proud here at Daybreak, I can tell you that, and we salute you this morning. Now, you went through basic training for the National Guard in Fort Benning. Now, we touched on that just a minute, but talk about that a little bit more.
Well, just for starters, Fort Benning, Georgia is the hottest place you'll ever be in the United States, I swear. It was terrible while I was there, like I said before, but you meet a lot of great people. You know, you bond with your platoon, and you learn a lot of good life lessons, mm-hmm. You know, the Army values, integrity, honor, things of that nature.
So what were some of the most difficult parts of that basic training?
The ruck marches, by far.
Now, what is that?
So we get up at about 2:30 in the morning to get ready for a ruck march, and we throw on 60, 70 pounds of gear in a ruck march. Full OCPs, which is our uniforms, and we'd ruck. Our longest ruck was about 17 miles to a training location, but they wouldn't be so bad, but unfortunately for my platoon, every time we went to do something, it rained. Mm. And it rained the entire time, and it kills your feet because they're soaked.
So how has the basic training or being a part of the National Guard at Fort Benning, and you were there 2.5 months. How has that helped you as far as an individual heading into your senior year?
Well, it made me a better person, to be honest. It taught me one big life lesson, and it is to be more appreciative, because whatever you're going through at any time, it could always be worse. And I learned that the hard way. I went in there thinking it was going to be pretty easy, and it taught me quick.
Talk about a little bit what you're taking as far as classes in school.
Okay, so I'm taking AP Literature, Physics, AP Calculus, AP U.S. Government and History, Spanish 3. I have an elective period where I don't do much. It's really just a study hall. Let's see, first, second. Yeah, that's pretty much the extent of it. I got most of my credits that I needed last year. So this year would be a fairly easy year.
Do other students look at you any differently as what your summer entailed and what your future is going to entail as far as military?
I'd say they do. I get a lot of respect, and it feels great. But within my small friend group, they still see me as normal John, just with shorter hair.
Yeah, fantastic. John Murphy, senior B.B. Comer with a 3.7 GPA, and he is going to finish his contract with the National Guard, and then you're going to switch over to active duty with the Army. What do you want to do there?
Well, I originally had planned just staying National Guard, but after this summer I realized there's a lot of potential in it to have fun and expand my career. I do plan on going to officer school one day, I believe, but I think active duty is just for me.
Yeah.
I just couldn't do it in high school because you can't be 17.
Yep. John Murphy, 17-year-old senior over at B.B. Comer, and he went to basic training with the National Guard at Fort Benning this summer. There, 2.5 months. You missed your entire summer vacation.
I did, but it was worth it. And I also missed about 3 weeks of school, but I'm catching up all right.
So you're just actually getting back, right? Not long ago.
Last week, yes, sir.
Yeah. And your family, of course, you got three sisters, right?
Three sisters and two brothers.
Who are they?
Well, one sister is living with me right now. That's April Murphy. Megan Murphy and Chrissy Cantrell both live in Oklahoma, real close to each other.
Okay. What do you do for, like, with as active as you've been this summer with the military and stuff like that and training, what do you like to do to relax?
Honestly, taking naps is one of the best things to relax. Just quick, brief little, close your eyes, think about stuff.
Yeah. You watch any movies or anything?
Over the summer? None, no.
What'd y'all do when you weren't working there?
We were pretty much always working, but if we weren't, drill sergeants are very creative at coming up with things to do to pass time. Even if that is on the night of your graduation, you're on your hands and knees sweeping rocks with a hand broom at 2 a.m.
Well, John, we salute you for sure, and we thank you for, at an early age, I mean, here he is, just 17 years old, already went through his basic training with the National Guard, and will continue his contract with the National Guard and then switch to active duty with the Army. And you want to be a civil engineer?
In the future, I think civil engineering is what I want to do. Something in the engineering field, you know, I really love math and science.
So your senior year at B.B. Comer, you talked about some of the teachers there. Overall, who has impacted your life in a positive manner that you kind of look at and say, hey, I can go to that person and just bounce anything off of them. They won't judge me or anything like that.
Well, really, it's starting this year. I'm getting a special little bond with my ex-history teacher, Coach Lamb, because he was active duty service. He was an airborne ranger, and it's great to just to have someone to talk to about the insides of it.
John Murphy is our Star Student of the Month this morning. He is a senior over at B.B. Comer High School with a 3.7 GPA. John, thank you so much for coming today. And we congratulate you and salute you and your service to our country, and pray that the Lord will keep you safe.
Well, thank you, sir.
More Daybreak coming up right after this.